Hello, my name is Armand Martin and I'm the author of The Quantum Divine Nexus, a journey to unify science and spirituality to unveil life's purpose. Today, I want to have a short talk about one of my favorite topics that I also covered extensively in the book, time, specifically in how it connects with our consciousness. And the topic that I want to revolve around is the Chronon Field Theory. Now, the Chronon Field Theory is not an established theory in science. I have to want to put that in the front. But it is a theory that is investigated and that provides a completely new and fresh approach to physics and to quantum physics. So imagine reality not as a continuous flow, like water from a faucet, but as a series of still frames, snapshots flickering so quickly that our mind have to stitch them together in what feels like a seamless motion. What if time isn't a river, but a sequence of beats, like the ticking of a metronome? And what if the truth about time is that it doesn't flow at all, it just exists? This is the essence of the Chronon Field Theory. Now, the Chronon Field Theory proposes that time is not a smooth continuum, but instead composed of tiny, indivisible units called chronons. Each of these chronons represents the smallest possible increment of time, like the pixels in a digital image or the frames in a movie. This theory challenges the traditional view of time as a continuous flow, as described in classical physics, and could potentially replace it with a model where time itself is quantized, much like energy in quantum mechanics. It provides like a new framework for understanding phenomena in both the quantum world and the structure of the universe, suggesting that time has a granular, very fundamental structure. Think of an old flip book. Each page is a static image, but when you flip through it quickly, the drawings appear to move. Our universe might operate similar with chronons as the individual pages. They're the smallest possible units of time, snapping one after another to create what we perceive as continuity. Another metaphor I like is reality as an ocean. The chronons are like the individual water droplets, each for itself, but when combined, they create the vast dynamic body of water, what we call the sea. The waves rise and fall, currents flow, but at their core, they are just countless droplets in motion. Similar to that, our perception of continuous time and reality is built upon these countless chronons flowing together seamlessly. Without the droplets, there's no ocean, and without chronons, there is no time. But even more interesting is when time is really made out of these discrete chronons, then reality doesn't exist in between them. Like they are tiny, imperceptible gaps where everything, you, me, everything around us, the universe, simply doesn't exist. And in those gaps, we vanish. Reality flickers in and out of existence, much like a strobe light in a dark room. And this means that time doesn't flow. It's just a series of static moments that just exist, like forever. No beginning, no end. Now, what bridges these gaps? Consciousness. So our minds act like projectors, giving kind of a coherence to this flickering reality. Just in a movie, is meaningless without a projector. The universe chronons need an observer to create the illusion of flow. This is like described by quantum physics, where particles don't settle into a definitive state, wave, or particle without an observer. Or let's imagine you're driving in the night on a dark highway, and there's a blinking light coming, and when you see it going on, you see the street, and when it goes off, you don't see it. So what your brain is doing is it's connecting these bits together, and it's like the Chronon Field Theory, that it just does it at such an unbelievable speed that we perceive it as steady. And it's like a sequence of static flashes, and our minds stitch them together to create the illusion of movement. Now, what does this mean for free will? If reality is reconstructed every chronon, then each moment is actually a fresh creation. So our choices aren't bound by the unbroken chain of cause and effect, but are like micro creations happening billions of times every second. This redefines what it means to exist. You're not moving through time. You're existing in countless still moments put together by consciousness. So, for instance, the next time you feel stuck in life, remember, reality may not be a continuous path. It's maybe a series of cosmic snapshots. And with every flicker of the Chronon field, you are reborn. You are like freshly created and full of new potential. And perhaps the universe is giving you infinite chances to recreate, rewrite your story, picture by picture and moment by moment. So are you ready to flip the page? Now, in my book, I extend and explore the Chronon field theory as the missing link in physics and consciousness, trying to bridge these two fields together to explain a new view of reality. But that's not all what I'm doing. I'm even going much more further. I'm using the Chronon field theory to explain that this field needs a force in order to be not just created, but to be sustained. And this field that is always there is like the basic fabric of time, is nothing else than a field created by the creator itself, and as well sustained by the creator itself. These and many other ideas that shed a completely new fresh light on the fundamental questions of existence and that tries to actually fill the gaps in science that we have today with a more meaningful and a more purpose-oriented explanation of reality you all find in the Quantum Divine Nexus. Thank you for watching and hopefully see you back soon for another short exploration of one of the mysteries of reality.